And before I start talking about specific testing techniques, there's something else that I want to discuss, which is testing granularity levels. So let's consider a software system, a system made out of components that interact with one another. So the first level that we consider in testing is called unit testing, which is the testing of the individual units or modules in isolation. The next step is to consider multiple modules at their interactions, and this is called integration testing. So integration testing is the testing of the interactions among different modules, and it can be performed according to different strategies, depending on the order in which the modules are integrated and on whether we integrate one module at a time or multiple modules together all at once. And in this latter case, we call this kind of integration testing the one that integrates all the modules at once, Big Bang integration testing. And after performing integration testing, the next step is to test the complete system as a whole. And this level of testing is normally called system testing. So system testing is the testing of the complete system, and it includes both functional and non-functional testing. We will discuss functional and non-functional testing in details in the next two lessons, but I just want to give you an idea of what they are intuitively. Functional tests are the tests that aim to verify the functionality provided by the system. For example, if you consider the function double value that we saw earlier in the lesson, a functional test will try to assess that that function is producing the right value given a specific input. Conversely, non-functional tests are the ones that target, unsurprisingly, non-functional properties of the system. For example, non-functional tests will include performance tests, load tests, robustness tests. In general, non-functional tests will try to assess different qualities of the system, such as reliability, maintainability, usability, so basically all the utilities that you can think about. In addition to these three basic testing levels, there are two more levels that I want to consider and that I want to discuss, and they both involve the whole system. And the first one is acceptance testing, which is the validation of the software against the customer requirements. So this is the testing that makes sure that the system does what the customer wants it to do. And the last type of testing that I want to mention is regression testing. And regression testing is the type of testing or retesting that we perform every time that we change our system, and we need to make sure that the changes behave as intended and that the unchanged code is not negatively affected by the modification, by these changes. In fact, what can happen when you modify the code is that parts of the code that are unrelated to the changes are actually affected by the changes and start misbehaving. And we call those regression errors. And regression errors are very common. For example, you're probably familiar with a situation in which one software update is released and just a few days later, another software update is released. And in many cases, that happens because the first update was containing regression errors. So the changes in the code broke some functionality that resulted in failures on the user's machine and in bug reports, and therefore that caused further maintenance, further bug fixes, and the release of a new version. Something else I would like to mention about regression testing is that regression testing is one of the main causes why software maintenance is so expensive. And that's also why researchers have invested a great deal of effort into defining regression testing techniques that can make regression testing more effective and more efficient. So let me leave you with a piece of advice, which is try to automate as much as possible regression testing. For example, use scripts, use tools, make sure to save your hardness, make sure to save your inputs and outputs for the test, because you want to be able to rerun your test at the push of a button as much as possible every time you change your code to avoid the presence of regression errors in the code that you release.